can we know that we are acting for the pleasure of Krishna? And how can we know that Krishna is actually feeling pleasure from our activities?
How Krishna is?
Feeling pleasure from our activities.
Very correct. The very first one is?
How can we know that we are acting for the pleasure of Krishna?
You are acting. First of all, you are acting. But you cannot act according to your own desire. You should act according to rules and regulations. Isn't it? As per the instruction of your guru. Okay? If you are doing that one, you want to know whether Krishna is pleased or not. Isn't that your first one? Isn't it? If Krishna is pleased with you, what he will do? He will reciprocate you now? If he's not reciprocating, he's not a gentleman. Isn't it? If you are doing some favor to me, if I am not reciprocating that one, at least I should say thank you. Isn't it? He will tell you at least thank you now. What the thanks is going to do? The extent to surrender to Krishna, that extent is rewarding you. What is the rewarding? Your dedication. What all you have, the unwanted things that you are going to give up. You understand? If Krishna is pleased, the symptom is you are getting purified to some extent. Suppose if you are lacking something, he may give you something. Yoga kshemam vahamyaha. That one both. Yoga means like what you don't have, that he is giving. Kshema means you are happy. How you are happy? When your headache is gone, then you are happy. That is kshema. What all the unwanted thing you have that he is taking away, what you are lacking, that he is giving you. Isn't it? Yoga kshema. This answer for your first question. What is the second question? It's combined together, you got answer for both. So, Krishna's one action can
fulfill different desires.
Different pupils, different desires. Okay? So, anyone else? Yes?
Krishna.
He doesn't want to. He doesn't want to make Krishna feel pain. If somebody is telling, Prabhuji, I have lost this one, I got this from this problem, we are actually paining them. Isn't it? The person knows you already. You need not express that one. He knows that one. Sudama doesn't want to make Krishna unhappy by telling all his worries. You got the answer for your question?
Krishna already knows.
Yes, Krishna already knows. But we do not know why I am suffering. That's the problem. But Sudama is a great soul. So Sudama understands Krishna, Krishna understands Sudama. That's why they are the same. Okay, anyone else? Yes?
Some behaves nicely, some preaches nicely. So both the qualities, will it come at the due course of time, the devotee practices, or how?
20 years after also there is no change in you. You have to check yourself. That's why I'm telling you very often, you better to justify your activities with Krishna conscious principles. Isn't it? If that is not coinciding with, you have to change your behavior. I already told that one, your problems and your solutions are lying within you. You understand? So you cannot go and ask somebody else, I have this problem, you better help me. That's not necessary. As he helps, after some time you are going to face the same problem. But if you rectify yourself, you will never get back the same thing. Got the point? Very, very nicely we should understand this point, huh? These are all very good realizations, huh? Ourselves, we have to change ourselves. Don't try to change the whole world. If you change yourself, your world is changed. Don't bother for the rest of the world. Your world is changed. With all you are going to move, with all you are going to contact, that world will be very, very nice for you. You don't bother for the others. You understand? Try to change yourself. So even Christians also they pray, no? Oh my Lord, please change my heart. I was also in Christian school till that standard. Little, little Christianity also, you know. We had the chapel that's called the chapel. No? We'll go, there's the cross. Before the exam, they say anything, they go and keep their hand there and with the kneel, huh? Then they will pray. Everything is good, but different levels. So we don't want to find faults with anyone. Why you are thinking only about Sudama, Sudama? Here is very nice topic is going on. Sudama, I already told you Sudama about Sudama. No, no, not necessarily. The wealth is not the criteria. You understand? Your behavior is only the criteria, not the wealth. Those who have this so much wealth, they are rogues. They are unable to lead their lives. They are consuming some poison, some sleeping tablets. They are taking the germs in the rings. They are committing suicide. So wealth is not the matter. How you behave, what is your consciousness, that's very important. Try to become Sudama. Yes. Krishna? Within and without, yes. Krishna is within you. There is two things. One is Krishna is within you as Paramatma. Who is the cause for the Paramatma? In one lecture I explained very nicely in Bhagavatam. Samkshirasagara Vishnu. Kshirasagara Vishnu is expanding so many Paramatmas. And in each soul, next to that one is Paramatma. That is for the living beings. And for this dead matter, material things. Material things also having atoms. That's why in each atom, Paramatma is there. Dead matter, we say, the dead matter will never act. Because absence of soul. But they do act. Isn't it? You did chemistry? H2 plus O2 is that gives? H2O2 gives 2H2. They are the dead matter. How they react? Because of the presence of
Paramatma.
Paramatma. Please understand, there is no soul. But Paramatma is all pervasive. Everywhere we can find Paramatma. You cannot say that he is not available. Okay? That is within. Within also in all the things we can see. Without. Within we understand, but we are not taking that much benefit out of him. Outside also. Outside means you are all outside for me. There also Krishna is there. Within, Krishna externally manifested. Within me also, Krishna manifests. Like that one in others also, Krishna externally manifests. Okay? How we are accepting a guru? The person who can visualize the qualities of Krishna in others. It's not that one, he is very nicely singing, he's very nicely preaching, he's very nicely dancing, he got so many disciples. That's not the criterion. You have to visualize the qualities of Krishna with a person. Then you should have the firm determination that this person can take me Goloka Vrindavana. Then you should accept him. If they don't have qualities of Krishna and you are accepting him as your guru, you are misled. That's why by the mercy of Krishna we get guru. Don't blindly choose. You have to see the Krishna's qualities. Krishna is not going to come here, he's not going to descend here. He can manifest externally. So he is there within and without. So it's easily we can understand. Krishna is telling so many inconceivable way also. Everyone is coming from me. Everyone is resting on me, but I am not in them. It means what? He is transcendental to all these things. They are influenced by Maya, three modes. I am everywhere, but others are influenced by Maya, but I am not influenced by three modes. So in that way, he is not in them, as though he is everywhere. You got the point? The quality of the Krishna is transcendental. Our quality is not transcendental. Ours is influenced by Maya. That's why he is not within us. As though he is pervasive in all places. So he is within and without. Everywhere he is there. One more point is, each and everything is the energy of Krishna. We are also energy of Krishna. Even the demons, demigods, all are the energy of Krishna. But we are all the part and parcel. The part has a little independence that we are misusing. That's why we have different categories of lives. If you all understand like this, when I told we are all eternal servant of Krishna, our duty is only to serve Krishna, but I'm punished to work for this boss because I got the attachment to my wife and children. Sadi Barbadi, in Hindi they say, Sadi, Barbadi means destroyed completely. Life's got destroyed. Bina Sadi, bigger day. One is spoiled. Why? He didn't get married. That's why he got spoiled. This both are there. Without marriage also he gets spoiled. After getting married, he is losing everything. And one more thing also they say, Delhi ka laddu khane se bhi fas jayega, nahi khane se bhi fas jayega. In all the ways we have all sufferings. But if you remember Krishna, that's the solution for all. Always remember Krishna. Do not forget Krishna. So your doubt is clear, Mataji? Anyone else? In this way, putting their questions, you can very nicely Thoroughly understand the things. Otherwise, it is not to pass the time. Yes, the time is over. The purpose is not served. We should thoroughly understand each and everything. In my school days, what the class is going to be taken next day. Today itself, I prepare all the subjects. That was my habit. That was my habit even in my school days. We have all the textbooks. So what the master is going to take the next day, today itself I finish off all those things. So we have to be, yes?
What's the difference between attachment and affection?
This is very, very, attachment means you are becoming blind. You are prepared to do anything and everything for that due to that attachment. The affection means it's not that much worse. Affection means you are appreciating something what they do. We can have affection for someone, but we should not have attachment for someone. If someone is doing, many devotees are doing very nicely, we can have some affection for that one. In that way we can help them also, because he is doing something good, so let me also extend my hand. That is out of affection. But the affection should not become attachment. Then that is turning point. Attachment is turning point. We can have the affection for those who are devotees. But we cannot have attachment to anyone. Babu and Vani also say, Guru. It is better to have Vani, then Vapu, isn't it? So this is very important, very nice question, attachment and affection. That's clear? You can have affection for anyone, those who are devotees.
Not for non-devotees.
What they do, appreciable activity. I don't know if they are doing something good in devotional service to please Krishna, then we can have the affection, but not the affection, it's the attachment for anyone. Even with your wife, you cannot have attachment. That is very, very dangerous. Okay? Everything is clear? Everyone understand now the purpose of ISKCON? Today we did fifth one, two more are there. They are very, very simple. These are all just like repeating only. So please understand, our life also has some purpose. We should understand the purpose. What is our life's purpose? To
get the consciousness.
Get to conscious. Before that one, we have to become selfless, self-realized. We have to become self-realized. We have to act as though we don't see Krishna. We have to act as though we are seeing Krishna. Serve Krishna. Do everything for His pleasure. Then definitely, only one. This material, whole material world is going to inspire you to enjoy sensually. The material world is designed in such a way that each and everything is going to inspire you to have sensual pleasure. Only one thing is counteracting all this much powerful things around us, is only doing our sadhana. The sadhana is going to counter act all these things. Those who are not doing sadhana nicely, they got in sexual affair. Sexual affair considered as environmental. Sexual action considered as chains. Chains in a jail. They are chained. It's very, very difficult to come out. Only one way is doing your sadhana. In order, if you want to come out, when you are not coming out, you are in that activity, you will never get the mercy of Krishna. But what the pleasure you are getting is limited pleasure. If you come out that one and get the mercy of Krishna, you will have more pleasure than the sexual pleasure. Please understand this and all. Those who experience, they can only realize this one. But just by hearing and throwing one ear to another, then we cannot experience. This is the life. So each one should do very, very nice chanting. Father Tulli, I told that one, pronunciation is very, very important. You can see those who are chanting like Ram, Ramo, Hare, Hare, they are not that much successful. Please understand. I don't think so. Please try to. Even for that also, today I corrected, no? Saraswati. Many people, even today also, many, many great souls, they pronounce Saraswati Devi. Namaste Saraswati Devi.
Do you
have
an expectation for bliss during chanting?
Yes. Correct or wrong? You are not supposed to try to become blissful. Then it is the artificial. You are making your own thing. But you should get naturally. You should act in such a way that the nature should provide you. You understand? We have to live naturally, not artificially. You do that when chanting with love and devotion, you pronounce very, very nicely, you will become blissful. That's the thing, the taste of holy name. When you become selfless, when you have no taste for anything else, then you can have the taste for the holy name. You have some taste with something else, you will never get. What is the sloka? I forgot. Atha Sri Krishna Namadi. Atha Sri Krishna Namadi. Grahyam.
Na bhavet grahyam indriye. Na bhavet grahyam indriye.
This one, this tongue, you see, is very difficult to pronounce Krishna. Rama. No, I want to get that one. Atha Sri Krishna Namadi.
Na bhavet grahyam indriye.
Na? Na bhavet. That is not manifest. Na bhavet grahyam indriyehi. Sevan mukohi jivado swayam chaiva spruvati adaha. If you do that one, it's very, very difficult. Atasri Krishna Namadi. Na bhavet. That will not manifest. Grahyam indriyehi. The senses are very, very blunt. So he cannot even pronounce Krishna. Sevan mukohi jivado. Sevan mukhi. We have to use our tongue and our mouth. Tongue and mouth to glorify Krishna. When we are eating very palatable things, dishes outside, that is not going to give you the taste of the holy name. You forget that and you take the holy names. Sevan mukohi jivado. Swayam chaiva, that comes automatically. You need not artificially bring this one. Swayam chaiva, spurati hada, you will sense that one. In that sense, you understand? We cannot do anything artificially or mechanically. It should come naturally.
So you can be enthusiastic.
You should have that enthusiasm. The saying is like that one. Even if you are not enthused, you make others
end is. That's the thing, the end. Without what is the term? Enthusiasm, three things. Even I am also getting old. Ukshaha nikshaya dairyat. Ukshaha. The ukshaha is enthusiasm. What time is getting over? What going on? Ukshaha nikshaya dairyat. So the ukshaham should be there. Nikshaya means determination. Ukshaha nikshaya dairyat. Dairya means confidence, faith. These three things are very, very important. Enthusiasm, determination, and
confidence.
Faith. Nikshaya dhairya. Dhairya means be dhairya, patient, correct, patience. Patience, you have to wait till that comes upon you. You need not go there. Patience, yes, correct. We have to wait. Don't prove yourself innocent. Please wait patiently till Krishna reveals the truth. You do not prove yourself innocent. Wait patiently till Krishna reveals. That's the patience, not dhairya. Dhairya ragna, adhair mat ragna. Bhagwan ke dher mein, ghar mein, dher hai, andhera nahi hai. There is delay, but not darkness. So, in that way, we have to understand this. This sloka is very, very important. Atha Sri Krishna Namadhi, na bhaved, grahyam indriyaihi, sevan mukohi jivvado, Swayam Cheva Spuratyatha. We have to recite this one frequently. Then only we can get out to this one. Otherwise, it's very difficult. Okay, anyone else? Okay? Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.